Hi, my name is Ashley, and I'm a graduate student here at MIT. My colleague Allie and I are going to explain the relative distances of things in space. In 1961, when we put the first man into space, it was a magnificent accomplishment. And today, many people still dream of being an astronaut and going into space. But what they don't understand is how close space really is. Space is any point outside our atmosphere where the air molecules are really far apart. And because our atmosphere is only 60 miles high, that's how far it is to space. Can you imagine? That's like driving from Boston, Massachusetts to Providence, Rhode Island. Wouldn't it be great if we could drive straight up to space? It would only take an hour. But in order for the shuttle to get out of the atmosphere and away from Earth's gravity field, they have to travel at 3,500 miles per hour. At that speed, it only takes 150 seconds to get out of space. That's way above Earth's speed limits and would be a mighty big speeding ticket.
So why does it take so long to travel between the planets? It's because even though space is so close to us here on the surface of the Earth, once we get up there, everything is really far apart. It's so far apart that it's hard to even think about. But we can make a scale model of the solar system right here in Boston to show the relative differences between the planet's sizes and distances. A scale model here means that every inch in our model equals 4,000 miles out in space. In our model, the sun would be as big as this baseball pitcher's mound here on MIT's campus, about 18 feet in diameter. How big and how far away is Mercury then? Let's go there now. In our model, Mercury is 740 feet away. That's just down the street from our baseball diamond, here at the entrance to MIT's football field. And as the second smallest planet in the solar system, Mercury is 0.76 inches in diameter, about the size of a penny. Venus, the second planet, isn't that much further, just another tenth of a mile down the road. Come on. Here we are at Venus, or at MIT's Kresge Auditorium, just over a quarter mile from the sun. In our model, Venus is the size of this lime. Next on our grand tour of the solar system is my favorite planet of all, Earth.
We're in Building 7, MIT's front door. It's also the location of Earth in our model. Right now, we're about 4/10 of a mile from where we started at the sun. As you can see, Earth is about the same size as Venus, only slightly larger. In our model, it's the size of this kiwi. At that scale, the Earth's atmosphere is incredibly thin, about as thick as only 3 sheets of paper. Our next planet, Mars, is just another 2/10 of a mile from here. I'm a bit tired of walking, but luckily I came prepared.
Mars is quite a bit smaller than Earth. In our model, it's only the size of a quarter. It's also over half a mile away from our pitcher's mound sun, at MIT's unique data center. Mars is the last of what we call the inner planets. Beyond that is the asteroid belt, and after that are the outer planets. This sounds like it's far away, and it is. Jupiter, our next planet, is 1 1/3 miles away. Looks like my scooter won't cut it anymore. Jupiter is so far away that we've left MIT's campus and headed into downtown Boston. We're at the Boston Common, 1.9 miles from our model's sun. Jupiter is the largest planet in the solar system. In our model, it's the size of this exercise ball. A lot larger than the planets we've seen so far, but still quite a bit smaller than the sun. Our next stop, Saturn, is over a mile and a half away from here. Man, space travel is tiring. By foot, scooter, bike, and now subway, we've traveled 3.5 miles from where we started. We're now at the Mystic River in Everett, Massachusetts. Saturn is the second largest planet in the solar system, and in our model, it means it's as big as this beach ball. The next planet, Uranus, is 3.5 miles from here, so we better get going. As you can see, the planets are getting farther and farther apart out here. We're out here at Revere Beach, with the beautiful Atlantic Ocean behind us. We're now 7 miles back from our sun at MIT. Uranus is a large planet, but it's not quite as large as Jupiter or Saturn. In our model, it's the size of this incredibly delicious-looking honeydew. Our next stop, Neptune, will take us up to Lynn, Massachusetts. That's 4 miles northeast of here, and 11 miles back from where we started. We find the eighth planet from the sun, Neptune, here at High Rock Park in Lynn, Massachusetts. In our model, Neptune is the size of this small watermelon. Now, technically, Neptune is the last planet in the solar system, but we still have one more stop, Pluto. Pluto used to be considered a planet, but in 2006, the International Astronomical Union reclassified Pluto as a dwarf planet. It's still a significant object in the solar system, but it's not quite on par with the other eight major planets. Pluto's status as a planet is still a big debate amongst astronomers. But we've already come this far, so we might as well keep going.
Welcome to Marblehead, Massachusetts. We're now 14 and a half miles from where we started at the MIT baseball diamonds.
Not only is Pluto really far from the sun, it's also really small. In our model, it's the size of this styrofoam ball.
It's about a third of an inch in diameter.
Now that we've reached the edge of the solar system, what's next? How far is the closest star? Can we get there today?
Well, the closest star is Proxima Centauri, which is about 2.5 trillion miles away in real distance. That's 25 with 11 zeros after it. In our model, that's 4 times around the Earth.
I think we had enough traveling for today.
Yeah, I think so too.
Let's head home.
Thank you.